Including cover crops in your crop rotation can provide many benefits. In general, those benefits are increased as you maximize your cover crop biomass. This is particularly true when your goal for using the cover crop is weed suppression in the following cash crop. Research has shown that 7,000 to 8,000 pounds per acre of biomass left on the soil surface is needed for good weed suppression. This amount of biomass can be intimidating to plant into, but it can be done successfully. To obtain a consistent stand, your planter needs to be set up properly. This video is designed to help you modify and set up your planter for success. We will cover components of the planter and tips on making these components function well in a heavy cover crop residue.
All right, so we're moving into the components of the machine here, and basically we're looking at a couple different things. Two that we don't have on this planter that we see sometimes are a cutting disc or cutting Coulter up front and a shank. A lot of times those are on kind of a tillage rig, but in this case, this is kind of a standard setup that we see. But if you had those two added, the cutting disc is actually going to help cut that residue so that the row cleaners here, and we'll talk about setting those in a minute, can move those out of the way. And then the shank's going to actually get down deep into the ground and help break the hard pan. That's needed a lot in coastal plain soils. All right, so the next add-on component that we're looking at when we go to plant into a conservation tillage or a heavy cover crop is row cleaners. So if we look at these row cleaners, these are just a spike build type. There's a lot of different types available on the market. And we want to set these, if you can kind of notice, there's a lot of adjustments here for the height. Once we get our planter in the ground and set, we want to set them just where they're barely touching the top of the soil, where they're actually moving residue, but not moving soil. If they're digging so deep that they're moving soil and creating a trench, that's too deep. We just want them to move that residue that's been cut and moved out of the way. And so these would be set where they'd spin opposing to each other, push a little bit of a clean trench out so that we can prepare that seed bed. All right, the next piece of equipment that we're gonna talk about here are our opener discs. So it's the shiny brown piece of metal that we see back here. And there's two of those in each row unit. So the job of these opener discs is actually create the furrow for the seed. And that's very important because we wanna create a good seed bed. What we're looking for here are these opening discs to spin freely and to also have very little contact right here on the front so that when they roll around, they actually create a seed trench. So that's why I have this piece of paper. You can use either a business card or a piece of paper folded a couple of times. And we can go to either the front or the back of the opener disc where we fill a gap, insert this piece of paper, and then roll the disc to make sure that it actually holds that paper there where it should be creating the seed trench in the ground. And so as long as it pinches that paper or that business card in there, like you're seeing here, that means that there's barely enough clearance in there, so it is creating that perfect seed bed. If it won't hold the paper in there without you touching or the business card, that means that we have too much clearance and we're not going to open a good seed trench. All right, on either side of the opening disc, we have what's called gauge wheels. These gauge wheels have a couple of functions. Basically, they're going to run right beside the seed trench that we've just created. So we want to look at a couple of things. These are first free spinning, that they're not wobbling, that they're not touching this opening disc too much, and that they are free moving when we lift them up and down here. And so what these, the main function of them is to set the depth of our planter. So once we set a depth here, these are only allowed to go so far up, allowing that opening disc to drop into the soil. So we want these to move freely here. If they're not moving freely, you can check the grease zerk here, grease that. If they're still not moving freely, you may need to consider replacing the bushings on that. Also, if they have a lot of wobble in it when you spin these, you need to check your bearings and bushings in here. So we've talked about creating a seed trench, setting the depth and all that. So one of the other critical elements that we want to look at is our seed metering system. And that is right here under our seed hopper. So in this case, on this Monosyn planter, I kind of have a little view window that I can open and see my seed meter in there. So there's a bunch of things we want to look for in there. We can take these seed meters off, check our seals, check our brushes, check to make sure we have the correct seed plate in there. So we want to make sure all that is operating correctly. This is kind of what we would call the central portion, one of the most important parts of the planter, because we got to make sure that we're putting out the right amount of seeds from the correct seed plate down into the dirt. And so as we drop those seeds off of the seed plate and out of the seed meter, they actually go down to the seed tube. So we have a seed tube right here on the bottom. It's kind of hard to see, but it's nestled between the opening disc down in there. And you want to check these. If you notice, there's a little pin on this one. I could pull this out if I wanted, drop it out, but we want to check and make sure these aren't cracked, worn, or broken, and also make sure that while this planter sat up under the shed over the year, that we haven't had any rodents, any insects, anything like that get in this seed tube and build nests and stop it up. So we want to make sure it's free and clear of obstructions. And if we're running a monitoring system on that seed tube, make sure that that's clean and clear so it's going to monitor our seeds as they fall down that seed tube correctly. Another critical component of this planter is actually setting the downforce, or that's the pressure that we apply to the row unit. So if we notice, there's a component right here on this planter, and I have actually four slots on it. These correspond, based on the manual, to 100 pounds, 200 pounds, 300 pounds, and this one to 400 pounds of pressure being applied by these springs on the entire row unit of this planter. So depending on what type of soil condition that we're planting into, we want to increase or decrease this downforce. So if we're planting into a softer soil or a wetter soil, we definitely want to decrease downforce. But if we're going into, like we're discussing today, a heavy cover crop scenario with probably a harder soil, you know, in a conservation tillage scenario, we're going to have to increase downforce some. And so on the monosem, it's just this pull pin. So all I would have to do is actually pull the cotter pin back here, pull this pin, and I could increase it by 100 pounds that easily. On a John Deere, there's actually a T-handle here. We lift the T-handle and put more tension on that spring. Downforce also helps us maintain a depth. So if we have a harder soil type and our planter does not want to stay in the ground, applying more downforce pushes that down into the ground and allows the gauge wheels to go up to where they're set so that we create that deep seed furrow. If we're not creating that seed trench or that furrow the way we want, if we're not applying enough downforce, we're not going to put the seed down to our required depth and we're going to have a stand issue. So it's very, very critical that we set this downforce to make sure that we maintain our appropriate depth, but that we don't set it so high that we're causing compaction issues. So we don't just automatically move this lever out of the way and go up to 400 pounds to create more downforce so that we say we're creating a good seed trench. In a lot of cases, that'll cause compaction issues. So there's kind of a fine line in here depending on what soil condition, soil type we're planting into, and tillage condition like we're talking about today, on where we want to be. All right, so what we've done up till now is we've created a seed trench, we've applied appropriate downforce, we've metered a seed, dropped a seed into that seed trench. So the last thing that we need to do is actually close it. So in this case, we're looking at closing wheels. So these are maybe not the best type of closing wheel when we're planting into a heavy cover crop. There's a couple of different options out on the market. We've got these solid ones. These are very common in this portion of South Georgia, especially for some of our cotton farmers that kind of like this type. But if we're planting into a heavier cover crop, we either want a pinched wheel, which would be two rubber wheels that are kind of pinching the soil and dirt back in here, or we want spike wheels back here. And what those spike wheels help do is break up any dirt clods or any heavy residue in there so that we close that seed trench really good and get a good soil to seed contact for that seed to germinate. The other thing we want to look at when we're talking about closing wheels is the pressure we're applying to those. And so this can be adjusted here, the back of the row unit, by adjusting these knobs. And very similarly, on a John Deere planter, there's a T-handle there. And so all they do, the same as we talked about with downforce, is put more or less pressure back here to ensure we're pushing hard enough that we're closing that seed trench. If we've got less pressure, not closing it well, that means that we're not going to have good germination and then emergence of that crop. If we've got too much pressure, the same as too much downforce, we can cause compaction issues and also hinder emergence. So again, there's kind of a fine line of where we want this pressure set on these closing wheels based on the tillage scenario and the cover crop scenario that we're planting into.
We've given you some tips for getting a successful stand and heavy cover crop residue. Making sure your planter is set up correctly will help you get the good, consistent stand you need. If you have more questions, contact your local extension agent for help. Happy planting!